Morning class, I'm Will Kemp from Will Kemp Art School, and today I'm going to show you how to get the perfect pink mixing the perfect pigment. I'm also going to show you how to mix the perfect purple using those reds. Okay, let's get started.
So here we've got a selection of reds that you'll most usually come across. We've got a cadmium red light, we've got an alizarin crimson and a quinacridone red. In artist quality, cadmium red is very expensive. It's a series 9 because the raw ingredients of cadmium are very, very expensive to get to start with. So let's lay them out and have a look what happens in their raw state and then when we add white. So here we've got the cad red light, alizarin crimson permanent, alizarin crimson and quinacridone red. You can see instantly that this one and this one definitely look the brightest, with the cad red looking real bright red. This is the light one, so it goes slightly oranger than just the plain cad red. That's a cad red medium. You see there's a slight difference between the two. Okay, let's add a bit of white and see what they look like. You have nothing. Dreams that came to you when so young. Told of a life where spring has sprung. See how this goes very, very salmon-y when you start to add white to it, rather than, you know, a bright, vibrant, pinky pink. When the armies of emotion go out. So this is a cad red medium. The wild earth sinks to its grave. You sail to the sky. Running out of space. On the crest of a wave. See, with this alizarin crimson permanent, I mean, you don't expect it to go this pink from having such a dark matte tone compared to this red. You think, oh, that's going to get a really, really bright pink. But suddenly, this one has gone a lot pinker. Strange face with your eyes, so pale and sincere. Underneath, this one goes a lot more towards purple, especially when you start to look in comparison to that cadmium red. For the dreams that came to you and so young. Okay, look at this bad boy. Spring is sprung. This is super bright pink. You would see so frail in the cold of the night when the armies of the ocean. So you can easily start to see, even though these are, again, I mean, they're not that close, but they're reasonably close. But when you start to add white to them, it always brings out the pinkiness, or always goes towards blue on it. So because of this cadmium red has got like an orange kind of bias to it, when you add the white so it goes towards blue, it kind of tones it down a bit. So this is, you know, quite muted. Whereas this one on the quinacridone, it's really staying quite clean still. It's always almost towards purpley, just in its pure form. So to try and get a bright purple, you really just got to look at these with white and see, okay, which is the closest one. I mean, this one's going to get a really bright purple in comparison to the cad red.
So let's have a look when we mix them with the blue.